People, welcome to this video. We are going to see how to use the new Adobe InDesign CC and the very basic things you can do. If you are searching for something in detail, check the index in the video description. It's appreciated if you leave feedbacks in comments. First of all, InDesign CC is a software used to publish files or pages. For example, to project pages of books, magazines, or make promo flyers and advertisements. This is the best software in print and digital publicizing, with images and text. In this video, we will see the very basic tools this software has. Then, in the next videos, I will show you how to make a project for good. Let's see how to start. Just go to File and then to New. Basically, you will use the document and the book files. The document is identical to a single sheet of paper or a group of them. The book is a file that collects more documents altogether. Just create your first document. In the new window, choose the number of pages and the size of each page. Through page size, you can choose the kind of document. Change intent to change what kind of presets to load. Depending on what you choose, a new set of standard sizes is shown at the bottom. For example, the latter has its own standard sizes, and so the other kinds, like the European A5, A4 pages, and so on. However, you can always set a personalized size, typing side height and width, but this is not recommended if you want to print or export the file later. Set the right orientation and the margins at the bottom. This sets a safe zone between the edges of the page and its content inside. Then just go to OK. If the document has more pages, the workspace shows you their order. The first page starts from the right and the second page from the left. First of all, a quick basis about the visualization. Hold down and use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Hold space down to activate the end tool, and click and drag your mouse to move through your project fast. If you want to zoom carefully, click on the lens button on the left, and click and drag an area to zoom it. Let's try to put some design elements inside. All you need in InDesign is inside the tool panel, that is usually on your left. Whenever you don't find Windows because closed, you can open them again, going to Windows section and clicking on the window to be opened. So to add the straight lines, use the line tool and drag your mouse. Editing it is very simple. Hold Ctrl down to edit the line just drawn, such as its length or position, dragging its central point. Green guides can appear helping you aligning objects. Then you can use the panel on top to change anything of such line, such as its angle, its stroke kind and color, its size, its rotation, and so on. This is called the control panel, and you can open it through window and then control if you don't have it. You can use the transformation tool as well. Just right-click on the button to select to scale, rotate, or share. You have this sublist every time the button has a light bottom right corner. Between these tools, you can use the free transformation tool, just practice. The pen tool is simply the same, but it lets you create curved lines. Click on and on to create straight lines linked. Then, when you want to create a curved line, click on a point and drag your mouse. At first, it won't be easy, but practice will help you at using it correctly. Hold Ctrl down to edit its points and the curved lines as well. Then use the panel on top to edit it properly, as seen with the line tool. To know how to draw professionally with the pen tool, watch the related video. Use the pencil tool to draw a line freehand. To select an object, just hold Ctrl down and click once on it. If you drag the mouse instead, you will select more objects at the same time through a selection area. Keep in mind that each of these objects is ruled by the layer window. The colored path shown when items are selected, is the color of the layer they belong to. If you just see such path, the object is invisible, so just add some stroke on it to make it appear. Through this panel, you manage objects or the wall layer with all its objects inside. Very useful is this eye icon. Click on it to hide an object or the wall layer. This is useful if you have a lot of objects disturbing your workspace. Object selections can be done through this window as well, clicking on the little square on the right. Keep in mind that this order is important. A layer A on top of another layer B will be shown on such layer B in your workspace. So the order of the layers, set the order according to which the objects are shown overlapped each other. Simply click and drag an object's row to move it from a layer to another. Remember that you can create a layer going to create a new layer anytime. Use the trash button to delete the layer selected. Mind that this will erase all its objects inside it as well. The polygonal tool is used to add polygons. You can choose rectangles or ellipses as well through the button sublist. These objects, instead of the lines, can have filling inside, which is represented by the square above the stroke in the control panel. You can manage this object exactly like the lines just seen. Strokes and fillings are represented by the squares below the lens icon too, and you can change their colors going more at the bottom. Double click on it to open the color window, and double click on the square interested to choose the color. To remove the color, which means removing the stroke or the filling, just choose the color represented by a white square with a diagonal red line. You can add the gradients to the stroke or filling. Let's add a color gradient. Go to Window, to Color, and then to Gradient. Remember to have selected the object first. This will be black and white by default. You can set its color clicking on the colored rectangles and changing color through the related window. Click outside to add more rectangles and personalize your gradient. With a gradient indicator selected, open the color window to change its color. Drag an indicator outside to delete it. You can add the gradient to the stroke or the filling, selecting between the two on the left. Use Gradient Swatch tool to set properly the change between colors. Just click and drag your mouse to set a line. Its direction will be the direction of the gradient, and its length the length of the color change. Gradient Feather tool does just the same, but puts feather on the object, with the direction defined. You can add further effects to your object. Just double-click on the Gradient Feather tool and check the effects you are looking for. Select the effect to edit it properly on the right. You can open the Effects window clicking on the FX icon in the Control panel too. Remember to select the object first from your workspace. You can personalize the stroke shapes through the corner options in the control panel. Just select through the second slot. To delete mistaken actions, just go to Edit and to Undo, or press Ctrl and Z from your keyboard. You can cut, copy and paste the object selected using Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C and Ctrl and V. You can use the Cut command to delete objects pretty fast. If you want to delete just single paths, just select the Eraser tool, which is inside the Pencil tool, and click and drag the mouse along that path. Let's now see how to import some text. To add some text, click on the Text tool, indicated through the T icon. Click on a point and drag your mouse to create a text area. This is used to contain the text you are going to type inside. Make sure that it is big enough to cover all its content. If the text box is too small, a red plus will appear on a side, warning you that the box is too small to show all the text inside. If you hold the Ctrl down, you can edit the box shape to show all its text, and you can move the box and its text inside by dragging the box from its center. Select the text first to change it. In this case, the control panel will show you all the options to edit text: the font, the size, the horizontal or vertical size percentage, the paragraph options, and so on. If you want to know how to create your first page with InDesign CC, check the next video in this show. You can change the text color using the color window and picking the right color. You can put color gradients as well. All seen with the objects works again. The effects are applied on the text only. The transformation tools like shape or rotation are applied on the text box, which will affect the text inside as well. Remember that the box is just an artifact to manage better the text and its position. Very cool is the type on a path tool. Just click on an object's path to start typing following such path. Then you can make the object invisible. You can just have this original text effect. Once your document is made, just save it. Go to File and to Save As, or just press Ctrl and S from your keyboard. Documents will be saved as .indd files. In the future, if you have a document with more pages, you can go from one page to the next or the previous one clicking on the Play Like button in the bottom left corner. In the Pages window, you can manage all the pages you have. Double-click on a page to open it. When two pages are on the same spread, both are shown in your workspace. This is different than a book file, since this one collects more .indd files together only. That's all. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Check our next videos to start creating your first page and project with InDesign CC. Thanks for watching.